free like the morning breeze.
Well, hello everybody and welcome back to the TARDIS. This is my second time doing this entire show because the first one turned out the battery was dying and the lab mic got it on the computer and had that hissing noise in the background. I was like, nope, no bueno. So, couple things to start off with. First off, live stream tomorrow night, 7 o'clock. That'll be midnight Zulu time, GMT. And it's a good possibility my buddy Ken may be with us tomorrow night. He's going to be in town and unfortunately he is attending a funeral of one of his friends, so, and we're getting to that age. Anyway, enough of that. We come here to escape reality, not swim in it. So, let's see what to talk about. Well, golly gee, all kinds of cool things to start with. I actually shot some video earlier. Now, finished the flying sub, and it came out okay. I left it in the natural color. I didn't bother to paint the yellow. God bless them, because we were just talking about how hard yellow is to work with, and it of course is exactly the color it needed to be, so all I had to do was put the blue trim on it and paint the interior. Looks fine. I'm happy with it. Definitely some blemishes and stuff, not a work of art, but it was a leisure build. Same goes for the Jupiter 2. It's done and they're both on the shelf. And the Jupiter 2 had a few fitting issues. Everything fit the way it was supposed to, but just you got a lot of blind, especially with the top and bottom halves. They have you put these pieces in the bottom and they have the pins that go up in the other upper half, and that's just trying to see what you're doing. And I had maybe gunked a little extra paint on a few of them, which made it trickier than it needed to be. But you know what? Straightforward build, no real issues. Had a good time. I made it like the way I wanted it to look because I just felt it looked so blasé with that, you know, basically off-white color and a little black trim, and hence a goal that, nah, I can do better than that. Let's beat this thing up. I mean, come on. We all saw the show. We know how the Jupiter 2 got treated. I mean, the movie, I mean, they only flew it through a planet. It was disintegrating because that was not total. Okay, you know, let's just not go there. But still, the model, let's just say the model was better than the movie. And that's my story. I'm sticking to it. So, also, the flying sub, again, it was just, it's a very snug fit. You got everything lined up just so. Nothing particularly hard, just a little aggravating. Took a lot of tape to hold the edges down, and I mean the good tape, to really hold a tight seal till the glue could bond. So I recommend using tape, because with those slopes, you're not going to get anything, clamps to hang on to it. So those are done. I brought out four more models to start on. Two Gundams, a submarine, and a dragster. And since we've been talking about dragsters, and a glue trooper had sent me one, I was like, you know what? Perfect time to do it. In fact, I actually did some recording earlier today. Now, I got to warn you, I'm going to block it out, but it was really warm in here, so I didn't have my shirt on. So since I don't want to burn out any retinas or anything, or cause anybody's eyebrows to catch fire, or apparently cause some forms of insanity, I'm going to block that part out, but let's talk about what it did. And also, we want to talk about that perfect grade Gundam. That thing's a beast. I did an unboxing of it, and I'm going to go into how I've got things arranged for the build. I did get started on the Ultimate Gundam today. It took me an hour and a half just to get one leg done. That is a super complex kit in its own right, but everything fit really well. One or two little drops of glue here and there to get some things that wouldn't hang on, but not bad. I'll tell you what, let's go look at that video I shot earlier today, and then we'll come back. But don't worry, I'll be here. I'll wait.
Okay, I thought we might do an unboxing of this Gundam Zero Custom Perfect Grade. I know that unboxings aren't something we normally do here, but this is a interesting kit, and it's one of those that probably, I think there's some curiosity about it. Even not a Gundam guy, you're just wondering about what makes a perfect grade. So I figure we'll open it up, take a look at it, and I'll start laying parts out. I don't think we've opened this before. Maybe we did and I forgot about it, but here we go. We have the instruction manuals, which I'm going to have to read in considerable detail before we get going. This does look very complex. And here's another instruction manual. I think this one, yeah, this one's in Japanese. Okay, so we have some parts, trees, and Not sure what these cards are, but they have tiny little parts in there, so I'm sure they wouldn't put that in there unless they are very, very important. Material box. Okay, that's all in Japanese. It's all in Japanese on both sides. Let's take a... looks like these feel like metal parts. And then, of course, we have the larger plastic components. Okay, and most of these sprues are one color, although there's some multicolor ones later. This is going to be quite the production. Wow, we're dealing with a lot of stuff here. Yeah, this is not going to be a quick build by any means. And I'm planning to do this in stages here in the TARDIS, and this will be the only thing on my desk given its size and complexity. And I know these things aren't cheap, so I certainly want to do it justice. Wow. Just lots of little parts. Multicolor, more metal pins and springs. And multicolored tree, chrome. Here are the wings. And there is the last of it. So I'm going to have to read the instructions, obviously, and just go ahead and set all this, get it arranged, because this is going to require a build plan. This isn't something I just put together. Now, the unicorn Gundam, I'm planning to build in the kitchen to keep these two separate. And I think the reason I want to do something like, by the way, if the audio sounds different, it's because I'm not using the lavalier mic. I'm still prancing around with the upper half of my body in the fridge, and I'm sweating. It's warm down here, a little humid too. Anyway, okay, I seem to have the perfect grade Gundam sort of organized in a way. Since I moved all my paints, I used to keep my paints in these trays, but now that they're over on the paint rack, I have these empty trays. So although this is just an initial organization, may change as I go through. I've got the black parts here, the more black parts here, the white parts here, and some of these other color parts are in the same plastic. Then the multicolor parts here, then the gray and black combo parts down here, and I have all the other stuff in this box. So now at least I have a way to spread things out and sort of keep them organized.
Okay, so I got that all organized. I haven't started work on it yet. I was able to clean the TARDIS up. I spent about half the reason I didn't have my shirt on earlier was I was breaking a sweat because I was out here cleaning the TARDIS up. But I've got room over here. I've got room over here. I've got room over here. I mean, the thing hadn't looked this good in a long time. And because of the extra space, I thought about even going ahead and getting starting on one of the other kits, but I might need this other space for that perfect grade Gundam because it's a beast. So also the dragster starting off good. I'd watched a video on making a kit similar to this one, and I decided to, as somebody had noted in the comments earlier, use the instructions as more of a guideline. But since it came with a lot of chrome parts, of course I had to shave all the mating points off of those, and I got some sub assemblies going. I'm doing the frame first. It'll be easier to glue it all together first, shoot it aluminum. And the nice thing about a dragster is you can fit all the stuff in afterwards. I don't know how much I'm going to detail out the engine, but I know a lot of guys add all of the ignition wires and oil lines and stuff, and the nice thing about a dragster is I can finish it, put it on the shelf, and then at a later point I want to drag it out and then add that stuff because it's all exposed. The one neat thing about dragsters is access. As my dentist says, access is success. So, Ricky the Wolfman sent me a message. He is 3D printing these things in several different sizes. They're basically drag chutes. And he was asking if I could put a notice up there. Now, you get these, you contact through the Facebook page. I'll link it below. And they look pretty neat. It's funny that I got this right as I was starting the dragster. I was like, there's a little karma for you. So that's where we're at with those. I built that submarine HMS Astute by Hobby Boss. No issues. Went right together. It uses top and bottom clamshell. It took about 5 minutes to put this thing together. And one of the things they do that's really cool is you have the option of the flush top of the sail, which people often mistakenly call the conning tower, or you can have the open one and put the periscope sticking up and everything. I'm doing it flush. And I've got it, I went ahead and just shot it in a basic coat of black. I'll put the decals on it and then weather it later. You might need a little gap seal. I mean, the top and bottom seal up very nicely, but it's still a body length seam, so you may want to do something with that. But it really, it's not a big deal. I mean, it's a really nice fitting, straightforward kit. No issues, no complaints. There are only about a dozen parts to it. And I would warn you that the base, the little base they give you for it, which is actually quite nice, has a couple of little nibs sticking up, but there's no holes in the bottom of the sub, which I think is a nice touch. That way, if you don't want to splay it on the base, you don't have these unsightly holes in the bottom of the submarine. But you can drill your own holes. I decided to go ahead and just grind off the nibs. I'll just use a little wax or something to tack it in place. But neat little kit. And now I've got two bases covered, almost. I haven't quite finished the submarine, but two bases covered for the watercraft build, although I intend to build something else for it. But I want to get started on these other projects, keep the channel moving along, and had a nice day of building today. I've got things to do tomorrow. Won't be a morning video because I'm going to be spending the day getting stuff done, getting ready for the live stream. Amongst other things and several topics that were sent to me by people, one of the things we're going to talk about is weird stuff you've had to do to hold a model in place while the glue dried. You know, how many of us haven't stacked up paint bottles or something and weird other things and books and whatever we could find in weird directions to get that thing to sit just right. And another thing we're going to be talking about is the F-104 Starfighter. Apparently quite a content thread got started about that. And that actually kind of emanated a Mike Mashat's channel, but and the Box Art Den, but it's something worthy of talking about. And we'll talk about whatever you guys want to talk about. I've had a couple of suggestions send my way and see what I can dig up on them. I've had some folks ask me to do if I could step up the kit model company history videos, and if I can, I will. We're going to do one on Mach 2. Got some information there. Got a little information on Kibli. Some information on Panda of New Zealand, which is a little hard to find information on. Got to thank Paul for most of that down there. He sent me a lot of stuff because I haven't been able to find anything online. And I'm looking at a couple other companies. You know, the more of these we do, the more kind of esoteric it starts to get because you've kind of done the big names after a while. But that's what we have for tonight, guys. I hope you're something keeps moving outside there. I better go check that out. I'll see you guys later, and as always, model on. And yes, I know, I've seen that movie too. Never get off by yourself, but I got, you know, something's going on. Yeah, okay, that was a mistake. Yeah. One, two, there we go. And here we go again. Happens.
Okay, let's hit the transportation button. My wife gave me this, and she said, she used it for her threads and bobbin stuff, and she's not going to use it anymore, so I told her I'd bring it to TARDIS because I might find a use for it to help arrange some stuff, so I don't know what I'll do with it yet, but I have trouble throwing away anything that helps you organize stuff.
Well, hello, everybody. Did I just do that on camera?